I want to tell you a little bit about an exciting project that we have here, which is the Center for Transformative Garment Production. This is actually one of the InnoAir projects from the Hong Kong government, and you might wonder, what is InnoAir? So the Hong Kong government launched a major initiative, which is they call the InnoHK program. Within the InnoHK program, there is one subdivision which is on innovation using AI and robotics. So what we are planning to do is tackle the garment industry with AI and robotics. And so you might wonder, wow, why the garment industry, right? The garment industry is a very old industry, and what can AI and robotics do? In fact, one of the reasons why there has not been robotics in the garment industry is because it is a very hard problem. If you imagine robots for making automobiles, for example, it's quite simple, because the automobile is made out of steel, the different parts are very rigid. You actually don't have many cars that are produced each day off the production line. So for a robot, this is very easy to handle. Now, for garment, you can imagine a piece of fabric or even a suit or a shirt. It's very flexible. Every shirt that comes to have some unevenness to it. And you're making thousands and thousands per day. So this was always too hard for robotics to tackle. And yet the garment industry is trying to become lower cost, more customized. So it's a wonderful opportunity for us to bring AI and robotics to try to transform this garment industry. So this is what we're trying to do. Our particular center is receiving over $300 million from the Hong Kong government to work on this project. We have one partner, which is Tohoku University in Japan. And one of the reasons why we wanted to bring Japan in here is because, of course, they're well renowned in robotics. So the ability to bring the Japanese technology into Hong Kong and then to take this and then be able to transform a very traditional Hong Kong industry in the past, which has been garment production, I think is a wonderful effort that we're going to embark on. So then very specifically what we do within this center on this particular project, we have three primary aspects that we're working on. The first one is sewing. So you can imagine right now, it's actually still people that are sitting in front of sewing machines doing the sewing. We want to replace that with robots. But one of the reasons why you still have people is because you need the fine movement control with your fingers, you need the eyes to be working on this. So our first project is to see if we can develop robotics to do sewing. Then the second main part of this initiative is how to handle material, the fabric. How to handle, let's say, a shirt, a dress. Again, because it's very flexible, it's three-dimensional, it's a challenge for robots to be able to do this. So the second aspect is going to develop robots to be able to handle fabric. So you can imagine, I need to hang a shirt, I need to fold a shirt before I put it into a bag to send to the store. Even folding a shirt is not easy, right? I have to find the corners, right? And I have to fold it properly. It's difficult. Then the third major initiative that we're going to have in this particular project is what we call collaborative robotics. So how will robots work together with humans? So still in garment production, we will still have humans around. In the factory, in the manufacturing process. So our robots, which will be a part of the different aspects of the manufacturing, will need to be able to work with the humans. So even as simple as, I need to know where they are. I need to know what they're doing, okay, first, because this is the safety concerns, right? And then the second one is then, if I have a human that's also going to be touching and working with the fabric, how do I collaboratively work with this human? So the vision system needs to be able to see where their hands are, where their body is, and then be able to predict, okay, what is that human going to do next? Okay, and also be able to hear. As the human says, okay, I'm going to do this, or tell the robot, do that, you know, working together. It's as if two humans working together, except for one of them will be a robot. So that would be the third part, which is on collaborative robots. So overall, hopefully, we will be able to transform the garment industry, be able to make it more efficient, lower the cost, allow the garment industry to be able to be more customized, so that they can tailor shirts for a color or pattern. And all of that, actually, this is the aim for the government, is to create new kinds of jobs in Hong Kong. So, of course, not the ones working on the manufacturing floor, but the ones that would be designing the robots, designing the software or the AI that can then be sold, outsourced to the garment industry, whether or not it is some in Hong Kong, whether or not it's in mainland, whether or not it's in other parts of the world, and be able to then create both jobs and income for Hong Kong as we move forward. So this is the exciting thing that we're doing, and we hope that you all can come and participate. Thank you.